You live here?
Yes.
Well, maybe you know what a zombie is.
When a person dies and is buried, it seems there's certain voodoo priests who have the power to bring him back to life.
Horrible.
It's worse than horrible because a zombie has no will of his own. You see them sometimes walking around blindly with dead eyes, following orders, not knowing what they do, not caring.
You mean like Democrats?
The following has been rated PC for politically correct.
Pay attention, you just may learn something.
It's the Sage, Larry Elder.
Ed Schultz was named by GQ as one of the least influential Americans in the country. And Ed Schultz went on television, and he was not amused.
You know, look, if you do a cable show, you have a radio show, whatever, if you're fat and you got red hair, look, they're going to pick on you. That's the way it is. And I'm okay with that. Just spell the last name right. Now, and I know that Anderson Cooper floats around in that GQ crowd. I don't know if he's behind it or whether they're published at CNN. But let me just say, I'm kicking his ass. By the way, I'm very influential. You can go ask the governor of Ohio, and it won't be long before you can ask the governor of Wisconsin. So kiss my ass, GQ.
Class. That is one classy guy. Man, you look up class, you see a picture of Mr. Ed right there. GQ named him as the third least influential person in America, and he blames it on Anderson Cooper. And by the way, did you notice this? He said Anderson Cooper floats around with those people. Now, there's been some discussion about Anderson Cooper's sexual orientation. He's never acknowledged what it is one way or the other. The word float, doesn't that kind of have a connotation?
You know, if you do a cable show, you have a radio show, whatever, if you're fat and you got red hair, look, they're going to pick on you. That's the way it is. And I'm okay with that. Just spell the last name right. Now, and I know that Anderson Cooper floats around in that GQ crowd.
Okay, stop right there. I want to ask people to give me a call at 1-800-222-KBC. When you talk about somebody who may, I don't know anything about Anderson Cooper's orientation other than he's been kind of coy about it from what I've able to tell. If somebody may be gay and you say they float around, I'm asking, isn't that kind of a dig? Give me a call. Confirm or refute. I don't, 1-800-222-KBC. Isn't that kind of a dig there? Anderson Cooper floats around with these guys. Didn't he say that?
You know, look, if you do a cable show, you have a radio show, whatever, if you're fat and you got red hair, look, they're going to pick on you. That's the way it is. And I'm okay with that. Just spell the last name right. Now, and I know that Anderson Cooper floats around in that GQ crowd. I don't know if he's behind it or whether they're published at CNN. But let me just say, I'm kicking his ass. By the way, I'm very influential. You can go ask the governor of Ohio, and it won't be long before you can ask the governor of Wisconsin. So kiss my ass, GQ.
I think that was a slur against Anderson Cooper. Anderson Cooper floats around with that GQ crowd. Huh? Hello? Is this thing on? Anderson Cooper. See, he competes against Anderson Cooper. So he doesn't like Anderson Cooper because they're competitors. And he thinks that Anderson Cooper sicked GQ on Big Ed and Mr. Ed and made them have this list about somebody being the least influential. I know Anderson Cooper floats around with that crowd, that GQ crowd. I want to know whether or not he was making a dig. I think he was. 1-800-222-KBC with the news. Here is Larry Elder here, and I will not be doing KTTV tonight. They're going to be doing a game and also going to be covering a lot of storm coverage, so I won't be doing it, but I'll be doing two or three of them next week. So those of you who are firing up your DVD, you can DVR, thank you, can relax. I won't be on. Aww. Now, let me just do this, set this up again in case you're just now joining us. I think Mr. Ed made a dig at Anderson Cooper. There is a speculation that Anderson Cooper may be gay. I don't know, and I don't care. He's even kind of toyed around with it, but he's never come out, assuming he is gay. And here's what Mr. Ed said about him. Somehow he's accusing Anderson Cooper of being behind the GQ article that listed Mr. Ed as one of the three least influential Americans in the country. Here is what Mr. Ed said.
You know, look, if you do a cable show, you have a radio show, whatever, if you're fat and you got red hair, look, they're going to pick on you. That's the way it is. And I'm okay with that. Just spell the last name right. Now, and I know that Anderson Cooper floats around in that GQ crowd.
Okay. Now, I want to know if that's a dig. It seems to me that's a dig. Tom is in Norwalk. Morning, Tom.
Morning. How you doing, Larry?
Fantastic. Thank you.
That's definitely a dig.
Think so?
Oh, yeah. I know so, because floating around, if it was a regular guy, he'd say hanging out or,
Tom, you're not saying that Anderson Cooper is irregular, are you?
No, I really don't care either if he is. If he's not in coming to my house or anything.
No, I mean, you call him. You said that's not what you would say with a regular guy. Implication is that would make Anderson Cooper possibly irregular.
That is right, irregular or gay.
Okay, all right. I was trying to save you, Tom. And you're just digging yourself in deeper. Andy is in Baldwin Park. Morning, Andy.
Listen, you know, over the years you've talked about all these vital, important issues, and, you know, I've agreed with you sometimes, vehemently disagreed with you on other times, and, you know, we've gone back and butted heads. But I got to tell you, Larry Elder, that on this particular issue that you're talking about, you have hit it right on the head. Yes, the use of the word float is clearly a dig at Anderson Cooper.
All right,
there's
Andy.
No question.
Andy, thank you very much. Chris is in L.A. Chris, what do you think?
Hi, Larry. Morning.
Morning.
I think it's a playful dig. It's not actually a malicious dig, and he can get away with that because he's a bloated Marxist propagandist.
Chris, also, notice he said, if you're fat, they're going to make jokes at you. Listen to this.
You know, look, if you do a cable show, you have a radio show, whatever, if you're fat, you got red hair.
Okay, you got that, Chris?
Yeah.
Now, you remember what Mr. Ed said about the governor of New Jersey?
Here's the bottom line. What we're seeing out of this governor of New Jersey is just go to the money, cut whoever you have to cut. There is no ramification for any of this because he's a cold-hearted fat slob anyway.
Ouch.
Yeah.
Ouch.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess so. He says if you're fat, they're going to make jokes at you, about you, and I guess he's demonstrating that they do.